In this video, you will learn how to create this part in FreeCAD, which is a completely free 3D CAD system. You will learn some useful operations for creating 3D solids. Create a new project in Part Design Workbench. Select Create Sketch and select XY plane as the sketch plane. Select Create Circle and draw two circles so that the centers of the circles coincide with the origin of the coordinate system. Okay, then dimension the circle, select constrain diameter, select circle and enter 50 millimeters as diameter. Okay, and select second circle and enter 60 millimeters as diameter. Okay, and click close to exit the sketch. And let's add another sketch, and this will be a sketch of the path to extrude the profile. Select Create Sketch and select XZ plane as the sketch plane. Select Create Polyline and draw a polyline so that the first point of the polyline coincides with the origin of the coordinate system, so that the second point lies on the y-axis, and place the third point here. Okay, right click to finish drawing polyline and right click to cancel this command. We will dimension it in a moment, but first select constrain preserving sketch fillet and select this point. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select constrain vertical distance, select this line and enter 50 millimeters. Okay. Then select constrain radius, select this arc and enter 50 millimeters. Okay. And now select constrain distance, select this line and enter 50 millimeters. Okay. Right click to cancel this command and select this line and select constrain angle and enter 120 millimeters. Okay. And click close to exit the sketch. And in the moment we will add a sweep, but this operation works better when we have a starting profile and an ending profile. And to create the end profile, we need a reference plane that will touch this point and will be perpendicular to this line. To create such a reference plane, hold down the Ctrl key and select this point and this line and select create a datum plane and here select normal to edge and click OK. And now instead of creating the sketch from scratch, let's just copy this sketch, select this plane and select create sketch. And to copy the sketch, select create carbon copy. And with the Ctrl plus Alt key pressed, select the previous sketch. A copy of the sketch has been created. Click close to exit the sketch. And now we can add the operation of extruding the profile along the path. Select the sketch of the initial cross section. Then select the additive pipe feature. Click the object button and select the path along which the profile will be extruded. And in this case, it looks good without selecting the final profile, but to select end profile or intermediate profiles, select multi-section as transform mode and click add section and select the end profile. Click OK. And we have the main part of the model. Now we will create the other parts of this model, and to make things easier, I will undo this operation. After this, the model will not obscure the view, and you will not need to turn off the model visibility. And the operation additive pipe is very easy to add, and we will add this operation once we have all the sketches. Okay, let's undo this operation. Select create sketch and select XY plane as the sketch plane. And some sketches and the reference plane obscure the view a bit, so let's switch to model tab and turn off the visibility of these features. Select it and press spacebar. Okay, let's go back to Tasks tab and let's select rounded rectangle and draw rectangle. Okay, right click to cancel this command and now select this point and select constraint symmetrical. Select this point and constrain horizontal distance and enter here 100 millimeters. Okay. Now select one radius and select constrain radius and enter 20 millimeters. Okay. And now select this point and select constrain vertical distance and enter here 80 millimeters. Okay. Now let's create four circles. Select create circle and draw four circles in these places. And now we will dimension it. Right click to cancel this command. Select one circle and select constrain diameter and enter 10 millimeters as diameter. Now select four circles and select constrain equal. Now select this point and y-axis and select constrain symmetrical. Now select this point and x-axis and select constrain symmetrical. And now select this point and select constrain vertically and select this point and select constrain horizontally. And thanks to these constraints, all circles are placed symmetrically. And now select the center of this circle and the center of this circle and select constrain horizontal distance and enter 75 millimeters. Okay. And select this point and select constrain vertical distance and enter 55 millimeters. Okay. Now we need to create a circle that has the same diameter as this circle. Select create external geometry and select this circle. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select create circle and draw a circle so that the center of the circle coincides with the origin of the coordinate system. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select this circle and this circle and select constrain equal and click close to exit the sketch. Turn on the visibility of the reference plane and other sketches. And now we need copy of this sketch on this plane. And we can do this as before with sketch carbon copy. Select this plane and select create sketch. Select create carbon copy and press Ctrl plus Alt and select this sketch. A warning appeared. Let's remove this constraint. Okay, I will rotate the view slightly. Okay, and as you can see, it doesn't work perfectly, but it's faster to copy a sketch and adjust it than to create the sketch from scratch. I'm going to delete this geometry and here we need to place this circle properly. Select create external geometry and select this circle. Okay, right click to cancel this command. Now select this circle and select constrain equal and select this point and select constrain coincident. And okay, click close to exit the sketch and now we need to rotate this sketch 90 degrees. And to do this, select this sketch and in attachment property, enter 90 degree as an angle. And okay, we have all the sketches created and here we only have a few sketches, but if there were more of them, it would be worth changing the name of the sketch. To do this, right click on the sketch and select rename and enter new name. You can also select the sketch and press F2 on your keyboard and enter a new name. And OK. I will turn off the visibility of the last two sketches for a moment. And now we will add the operation of sweeping the sketch along the path. Select the starting profile and select additive pipe. Then click object button and select the path sketch. Select multi-section as transform mode. Select add section button and select the final profile. And OK. Now let's enable the visibility of these sketches. Select it and press spacebar. Select this sketch and select pad operation and enter 10 mm as length and select reversed option and click OK. And now select this sketch, select the pad operation and here as before enter 10 mm as length and select reversed option and click OK. Let's turn off the visibility of the datum plane, select it and press spacebar, and we did quite a complex project. You have learned a lot of operations for creating 3D solids, and if you want to learn more, check out my other tutorials. I will put the link in the description of this video. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel.